You're with the news here. I'm Seher Zama. In the top focus, this is with respect to the pollution menace, the air pollution crisis that continues in the national capital with pollution levels that have once again worsened. The air quality has become severely toxic again. There's a thick blanket of smog and haze that continues to engulf Delhi. The air quality that is expected to get worse in the coming 2 days as well. And keeping all of this in mind, this is what has now been proposed by the Delhi government. It has released a draft of electric vehicle policy which is trying to bring down pollution. The AAP government is targeting to make 25% of all new vehicle registrations electric by the year 2023. And the owners of petrol and diesel vehicles, which are most of us here, all of us in fact, will have to pay more in taxes, including pollution cess, including a congestion fee, while the aggregator cab rides will also get more expensive owing to that congestion fee. Additional to this, an air quality parking surcharge, a road tax for luxury petrol and diesel vehicles, also in the offing in this draft policy.
This is to curb the pollution crisis in the national capital. While the Delhi government was working on a draft electric vehicles policy 2018, they have now put it out online for stakeholder and citizen consultation. Along with the fact that they put in subsidies for those opting to buy electric vehicles, and especially giving an impetus and push to electric vehicles in public transport, that includes e-cabs as well as e-rickshaws and e-autos. Certain people who will be using petrol and diesel vehicles will be taxed more according to this policy. Now, let me just put this into perspective. If you are owning a petrol and diesel vehicle in the national capital, you have to pay more in terms of pollution cess. Now, how much that will be is still not decided right now by the transport department, but that will be notified. You'll also need to pay a congestion fee, about 2.5% of the base fare if you take an Ola and Uber ride. So these are some of the measures that have been put forward for pollution combating. However, citizens will have to pay more once the policy is out.
Mira now has spoken with Jasmine Shah, who's the policy expert on pollution cess as well as electronic vehicles policy, and she claims here that this draft policy, which has been adopted globally, is now expected to come into force by January 2019.
How do you propose to bring forward the draft Delhi electric vehicles policy to be implemented? What is the deadline? How much time do you think it will take?
Our plan is that we are working on a blueprint where every 3 kilometers from any part in Delhi, within 3 kilometers, you should be able to access battery charging stations as well as a battery swapping station. Right. And once that is going to be available, the idea of range anxiety, where people say that if I buy out, what if I run out of battery, should not be there. Mm. Now, we plan to execute this we have studied actually many models by cities globally. And even we have discussed with a lot of charging equipment manufacturers in India. And the biggest constraint seems to be land. In terms of the timelines, we have just put out the policy for a month for public comments. We have received a lot of interest globally, I would say. A lot of people are enthusiastic. So by end of January, we are hoping that the policy should be put in action. Hmm.
Do you think that people would be ready to pay such a price in the national capital?
Many cities globally that have successfully piloted electric vehicles have actually put in place this kind of a regulation. And I feel that somewhere, all of us who live in Delhi also are so concerned about pollution that we shouldn't mind that if there are, if a little bit of the money from our own polluting vehicles is going into funding cleaner and greener model of alternatives, as long as that money is well spent, I think we should support the government policy for that. So what the current policy that we have just released the draft of represents is a very new approach and a very comprehensive approach. By offering a little bit of subsidy without thinking at all about charging infrastructure, without at all addressing the other concerns of people, is not going to lead into any kind of a mass scale adoption.
Let's get in further details. We have with us our correspondent Mohit Sharma with these inputs here. Mohit, effectively this green tax that we're going to be paying for, that the Delhi government proposes, is at the end of the day paying tax for clean air. They've not been able to do anything with the factories, with the industries, with the polluting industries. They've not been able to do anything with construction sites. But we, as vehicle owners, are going to be taxed for clean air.
Well, sir, first and foremost, we should put a lot of things into perspective. Delhi has been very desperately battling the issue of vehicles, public vehicles that are available for public usage. You see, there is already a paucity of the buses in the national capital. You know, you don't have the exact number of buses which are actually needed for the entire population to be catered for. Secondly, you know, there is an extremely high inflow of trucks that go through Delhi. They are not exactly supposed to be in Delhi, they pass through Delhi, so that too accounts for a lot of pollution. The third thing that you rightly pointed out is the construction, the ever going on construction, not just in Delhi but the NCR region as well. You see the budding satellite towns of Gurgaon.
Mohit, stay on with us, please. Let's get in a word. I'm also going to be introducing Mr. Narinder Taneja of the BJP with us on the phone line, along with environmentalist Vimlendu Jha. First to you, Narinder Taneja. How is this going to be workable on ground? Do you feel that this is something that can be implemented with a state government there that has been struggling at least to increase its fleet in public transport, to be taxing personal private vehicle users?
I think the whole policy, if I'm not even willing to call it a policy, is very, very, you know, short-sighted. The point is, Delhi people, I'm a resident of Delhi myself, we are already suffering. We pay taxes to the Delhi government through petrol pumps and their number of other taxes. What do they do with that money? Delhi is a rich state. Delhi is not like UP or Bihar. They're sitting on piles of money. The Delhi, you know, when they took over the Aam Aadmi Party, mm-hmm. the population of buses was up in the region of 6,000, which has come down to 3,600. Ideally, Delhi needs 11,000 buses. Now they're taking off, you know, EVs. Do they understand what is EV? Do they know anything about it? They just started with a tax. So they're basically punishing the people like us, or the residents who are already suffering. So instead of giving the relief, you're actually punishing them even further for your own failure, because you don't have vision, you don't have
a policy. That's right. But Narendra, at least they're out with a draft policy which they hope can work on ground. What has the central government done about this? Apart from the Union Environment Minister giving out fancy statements that we're going to be looking at cloud seeding, we're going to be creating artificial rain. We've been hearing that for the past 2 years. What else has the central government done here? We're all living in Delhi.
No. Now tell me, when did the central government say we will go for artificial rain? That was all Arvind Kejriwal talking about. That is the responsibility first and foremost.
Not at all. There are statements by central ministers saying that. Absolutely not, Mr. Narendra Taneja. I know what I'm talking about here. There are union ministers who've made this statement, and these statements have been coming since 2016. This is not something new.
No. Listen. When it comes to environment, taking care of the environment under the constitution is the responsibility of the state government. The central government can chip in with the help. But here, instead of...
But then why do we have a union minister as an environment minister? In that case, the position of a union environment minister should not be there.
No, I mean, if you want to debate like this, that's not the way to debate. You have asked the question, I know this subject.
No. Mr. Narendra Taneja, I'm looking at this as much a responsibility of the Delhi government as well as the central government, because the central government is sitting in Delhi as well. We would expect both governments to be doing something about this.
Person, stop this, Tutu Meme. If you have a question, ask the question and have patience to listen to me.
I am asking you a question, and I'm clearing up facts. Facts that you're not representing, Mr. Narendra Taneja. If you do not like my answers and the fact that I know my facts here, that's your problem, not mine. Let's get in a word here from Vimlendu Jha. Vimlendu, if you heard that argument here, this is a constant blame game that we continue to see between the central government and the state government. You have AAP government, which is out with yet another policy. Questions being asked on how this is going to be worked on ground.
Absolutely. I think Mr. Taneja is completely misinformed and was again passing the buck. Because clearly, central government has absolute, is a custodian and is responsible for India's air. And therefore, Delhi is in India. And therefore, Delhi's air is also the responsibility of the central government. And you are right. Last couple of weeks, in fact, last 10 days, there's been a lot of conversation. And Union Ministry of Environment has actually been doing these experiments on cloud seeding and on artificial rain. So therefore, for Mr. Taneja to
absolutely
not and then blame...
I'm glad you second that, because these are facts
absolutely
available to each and one
absolutely
of us.
In fact, just yesterday, they were actually looking for permission from Civil Aviation Ministry and from others. Now, coming back to the main point that you said, that in terms of electric vehicles. Also, this entire change of electric vehicles, landscape that we're talking about is also part of the central government's, there's something called FAME, and therefore the electric vehicles needs to be promoted all around the country. But when we look at, and the same thing, there's, Maharashtra and Telangana also has a policy around this. So it's not something Delhi specific. I'm very, very glad that Delhi government at least acknowledges for a change that 30% of air pollution in Delhi is because of vehicular reasons, vehicular pollution. Because all this while we've actually seen Delhi government also in denial throughout, blaming the farmers one day.
Vimlendu, we should not overlook another very crucial fact. The Delhi government for the past 2 years has been collecting. It has been collecting and sitting on crores of money in that collection here of green tax from heavy vehicles, from diesel vehicles, from trucks and heavy vehicles that enter Delhi. And they've been sitting on that money, which was meant to improve public transport and buy in more DTC fleet, which hasn't happened.
Absolutely, and that's what I was coming at. They're like, one, they don't acknowledge that there is the main source of pollution. They keep blaming the neighbors and other political parties. I'm talking about Aam Aadmi Party blaming other political parties. And also the amount of money, crores and crores of rupees that's actually been spent or that's actually been collected has hardly been spent in that sense. So from that point of view, at least there's some kind of an awakening that we see in Delhi government and the current dispensation in the state government thinking about electric vehicles. But at the same time, you need to understand that this draft policy sounds very, very good, but do we actually have that infrastructure in place? Also, where do we actually get our electricity from? 70% of India's electricity comes from thermal power plants. And therefore, we need to, there needs to be a holistic understanding and a solution paradigm on this rather than just show an eyewash. So far, I think it's a good move. How much of that move actually translates and transacts on the ground? How much of this political intent actually translates into political action and actual concrete change in the ground? As you rightly said, all this conversation is about private vehicles and not public vehicles. We still have a public vehicle deficit. 92% vehicles in Delhi are private vehicles. What we need is not more and more private vehicles and greener private vehicles. We need better public infrastructure, public transport infrastructure.
Absolutely. We need a formidable public transport system. That's right. Vimlendu, stay on with us. Getting in that input from our correspondent Mohit there. Mohit, in this draft policy, any mention of how they're going to be countering this with respect to people now not being allowed? Eventually, when this is implemented on ground, if people are not allowed to use their own private vehicles, any mention on how they're working on strengthening public transport in Delhi?
Well, sir, first and foremost, it does sound like a knee-jerk reaction once again by the Delhi government. We've seen previously as well on two occasions when an odd even project was brought in, and the entire failure of that was attributed to the fact that there weren't any public vehicles available. You see, the overall shortage in the number of buses has only gone, has only risen over a period of three years or so, and there is an important need to bring out new buses. At the same time, in this draft policy, if you look at it, they are essentially also going to be targeting aggregate vehicles that are app operated. So essentially, once again, targeting those public vehicles, which are available, some certain mode of public vehicles. So essentially, it seems that once again, it's the knee-jerk response by the Delhi government that is coming in. Over the period of years since 2015 and 16, we've been seeing how the Delhi government had proposed on several occasions that they would also be bringing in mist fountains, which were never actually installed. We had seen how air purifiers were supposed to be installed, and we recently, also saw the reality check of that. That even despite of them being called in, they were actually installed almost 1 week after the minister had actually said that they would be installed. So that is the reality check that is happening in Delhi. But at the same time, bringing back to the point here is that the only sense that we can get here is the fact that vehicles are not the only one that are responsible. We've already seen there are other issues which has to be tackled as well. We have construction, which is the first and foremost. We have the burning of crop residue. That is an essential one as well. So all these have to be seen.
That's right. And there is industry pollution, burning of garbage there as well. Let's get in a view. Yes, Mohit, stay with us. We're getting in one of our viewers calling in, Ramakrishna Iyer from Mumbai. Please go ahead.
What I would like to say is that even the, I just now heard about Vimalendra Joy and the BJP spokesperson. In fact, when I was calling it, I was told that it is always a tutu mame. Now, one government proposes a tax, which is obviously good tax because there was a congestion tax, pollution tax, all these things are good. But when they want to implement it
right.
for the betterment of the public, okay, now the other government opposes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what is this going on? Now, why? Why is it happening like this? Okay, every now.
That's right. We must have all governments working on this together on all sectors, not just vehicles causing that pollution here. Appreciate you calling us in. Let's get in a word here from our viewer, Garvit from Gurugram, which is, of course, part of the Delhi NCR region here as well, an affected party speaking out. Go ahead, Garvit.
Yeah. So my point is this, that every year stalemate, this is the every year stalemate, and every citizen confront with this problem every year, and we always see blame game in politics. I think this is the time we should end this. I mean, the politics, this should be end, there should be an end on this, because this has become a cumbersome problem, and the city, the all the political parties should be united against this, because this is the problem. Which is concerned with the the every citizen as well as this.
That's
is
right. But Garvit, do you agree with you being stopped? Let me ask you a very direct question here. Do you, apart from all the ugly politics here on this, do you agree with? Are you willing to stop your own car from using your own car, switching to an electronic vehicle here, and instead availing of public transport as well for the sake of fighting air pollution?
Let me tell you that I am a student and I travel and I use the metro. I commute and I don't take any kind of vehicle. I'm a college student, but I use metro, and I do. I am doing my proper duty as a citizen. But you know, the politics that should be an mm-hmm. end right now, because we cannot tolerate this anymore.
All right. Many thanks for sharing that personal view here with us on Mirror Now. Of course, choosing to use the metro instead of his own personal vehicle there, doing his bit to help fight air pollution. Our correspondent Mohit with further inputs in breaking this down effectively. Has this been calculated now, Mohit? In how much more money are we really going to be paying just to be using the roads? With all the multiple taxes here that the draft policy mentions.
Well, the draft policy, you know, it talks about how this entire, this supposed policy would be brought in 2023. So it's a long way for the government to actually initialize, and everything has to be kept into perspective. But since, it's almost 5 years or so that are left for this policy to be actually coming in and being in kept into consideration, it seems that the government would be working on it. And right now, you know, it will be hard for even the government to come out and explain this entire policy. Especially at a time when Delhi is in a dire need of a better public transport infrastructure. But at the same point, since the EPCA has also been asking all the states to keep a check on crop residue burning, as well as on the vehicles that pass through Delhi, it is likely that since all that has been kept into consideration, it is likely that the pollution levels may go down. But first and foremost, what we need here is the fact that we need better. A better public transport system, and only then can the government actually ask people to go off of their private vehicles. Because if there is absolutely no connectivity within mm-hmm. the city, how do you expect the people to travel? So that is one of the questions that the government is still posed with, and that is something that they would have to look out answers for.
Yes, Mohit, stay with us. One of our viewers calling in, Varang from Delhi. Please go ahead.
Yeah, I would just like to put my comment, being a Delhiite, it's that we all know that Delhi being the capital of India, and both the state government and the central government lives in Delhi. So it's about, rather than blaming each other, whatever taxes that you are collecting from the citizens of India, that people should know that where are you actually spending those money on. I mean, we can't, on ground, we can't see any kind of greenery. We can't see any kind of action that the state government or the central government is being, taking against this major issue, which being a child, being an elder, being a normal youngster, every school going, college going, everyone is I would say, undergoing the pollution effect, the lungs are, at the other day I was looking at the listening radio,
right.
The doctor was also like, you know, I haven't seen any pink lung in the last 10 years since when the pollution problem occurred. So, it's people from Delhi go...
Absolutely,
to
well pointed out. Where are the results showing for other tax collections here? There have been no green plantations in the name of a green cess in other taxes that are collected here as well, and nothing showing on ground. Remember, there has been a green tax already in place in Delhi, which has been for trucks, commercial vehicles, heavy vehicles. And this tax was collected so that public transport system could be improved. That has not happened in the past 2 years. What's trusting us that this would also be effective, new green tax here on private vehicles to be cleaning up our air? Many thanks for all of those voices here that have come in to speak to us. Our correspondent Mohit with those inputs here as well. It is a wrap-up.